Cristo es digno. We've come to magnify. 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 Come on, we call. We've come to magnify. We've come to magnify. We've come to magnify. We've come to magnify. Levanta, levanta. Welcome to Praise Center. Did you come to magnify God, magnify Jesus? And so did our choir 2.0. Don't they look great? And Susie, if you want to grab your mic, it's sitting right there for you. But we just want to worship God, and that's what today is for. We're just going to worship God. I have some word to give to you guys, but it's just worship today. So I hope you came to give God worship. I hope you came with your attitude ready. Because God's always ready. We're the ones that need to get warmed up, don't we? But God is ready. He's willing. He's just looking, right? And I hope he finds Praise Center ready. Amen? So there's joy in my heart.
Sins have been washed away.
ministry a long time, ever since I was 16. Believe me, that's a long time. But in everything that I've done, everything I've accomplished in life, this song says it all. And all I've ever wanted to do was give myself away so that God can use me. No matter what it was, no matter what he asked me to do, I wanted to be there. Wherever he took me, whatever came my way, whatever opportunity arose, I wanted the Lord to be in it. Because there's no success in this world without Jesus. It means absolutely nothing to gain the whole world, amen, but lose your soul. Give myself away.
Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that. Heaven's mercy, see. We'll greet one another. Children are dismissed. Youth, you are staying, remaining put, but feel free to greet one another. Gosh, I love that song. Oh, boy. Well, welcome, everybody. Welcome to Praise Center Church. We are glad you're here worshiping with us today. Those online, thank you for joining us as well. God bless you. We anticipate a really good service today. Jersey Sunday. I see jerseys. All right. I forgot to do this last week. I apologize. I had it on underneath. Some noticed I was wearing my my South African rugby jersey, and I wore my other one today. So South African rugby is my... When you live in South Africa and they happen to win the World Cup that particular year, it has an impact on you. So it was something else to behold. I'll tell the story some other time. But any was it Phillies, Astros fans, Phillies? Okay. So if anybody does have Phillies or Astros fans, pray for them this week. Okay, be sure to do so. I know what it was like for the Dodgers when they were in the World Series. That was... It gets nerve-wracking, and especially when it comes to big championships. But no, we're glad that everybody's able to join and have a little bit of fun wearing our jerseys today.
Amen. So ushers, you can go ahead and go and do that, because we have a whole lot of worship to do. And I love to worship. And I think Praise Center, it's in your name. You like to praise too, amen? But I wanted to take a moment to just kind of to speak a word that I really feel is in my heart to give to you guys. And this little sermonette is called The Big Picture. And I think as Christians, sometimes we face the most discouraging of times because we know how we're supposed to be, right? We read it in God's word, and we know what we're supposed to match up to. The world, they do whatever they want. They don't feel bad unless, you know, they have nothing left, right? Then they come crying. And us Christians, you know, we feel the conviction even when we slip up a small thing. And it can become very, very discouraging to walk this Christian walk in this world today. And so I wanted to give this message about the big picture. Now, we all remember school pictures, right? My favorite time of year. Now, I'm lying, of course. I hate pictures. Okay. I like to be the one taking pictures because then I can control it, not being the one getting pictures taken. And so I remember going to picture day, you know, and you'd have to pose there. They gave you a little comb, the black comb that carved your head. Oh, yeah, I remember that. And then posing for the picture behind that blue screen or whatever you did. And do you remember the packages they sold? Package A, B, C, D. Okay, this is package, go to package A. This is the one I always wanted and never got. I wasn't rich. So I mean, look at that. You had all these 8x10s, right? You had so many 5x7s, so many 8x10s. You can give one to grandma. Mom got one. Grandma on both sides got one, you know. And then the 5x7s, who got that? Aunt and uncle, right? And then if you had a boyfriend or girlfriend, they might be able to get that 4x5. It's a little larger than the others. And then you had 40 million wallets. Really, you felt like NSYNC signing them. Here, take one. Thank you. I don't know you, but take one. You have so many, right, that you had drawers left over, and you're like, wow, I didn't even know I had them. And you write this big message in the back, right? Yeah, stay cool or something. And then you give them out, right? You had so much you can give to everyone, even your enemies, if they'll take it, right? We didn't have a digital file back then. I don't think we didn't have computers or something. So that's all brand new. Apparently, you get a digital file now. And if you couldn't get this one for a gazillion dollars, an arm and a leg, you can get package B, right? And notice how package B, you kind of, if there's still a lot, but one of your grandmas don't get one, so you have to pick one. Yeah, and so everyone gets downgraded a little, right? Okay, so 5x7. Oh, you gave me a big one last year. Yeah, I had more money last year. Package C. Now we're getting to my area. Package C. We lost them. We lost some whole things, right? We only have a few. You have to pick your friends wisely on this one, right? Here's a picture. Don't tell anybody, okay? Right? We only had one of the large picture, right? The one bit, the big picture, right? And that mom took that one. Mom said, that's mine. Grandma, don't get it. That's mine, right? And then boyfriends and girlfriends, they had to get the small wallet, so they had to get like everybody else. Aw. And then, is there even a package D? There probably is, huh? Yeah. Now we're losing a lot, right? And they probably went to package G or something. And that one just had like the 8x10. That's it, right? And your photo in the album. And I remember that because I could never, ever afford package A. I always wanted package A, but I didn't have enough money. And I mean, if it was a way bigger sacrifice to get package A. I mean, I'd have to mow lawns and do whatever to have enough money to pay for that huge package. And so I ended up getting like a package D or Z, something way down there, okay? And I, as a kid, I didn't care about that, you know, but as I got older, you know, that really spoke to me. Because I began at 18 years old, I began volunteering as a chaplain in Corcoran State Prison. Now, 18, I was half the size I was today, since I'm a big burly guy now. I was very small, okay? And so going in there, my pastor Lonnie, she was an evangelist pastor, and she just, if you said yes, she took you. And I didn't know where we were going. And she took me to prison. Okay. 18 years old. Where are we going? Yeah. Just learned how to play piano. And then we go there and we drive. If you've ever been to Corcoran State Prison, Corcoran's out in nowhere, right? And then Corcoran State is out in the middle of the boondocks. It's really far out there on this dirt road that goes and takes you out there, just in case someone gets free and runs, they can catch them. Yeah. Okay. So we're driving out there, and I'm going, where in the world are we going? And when we got there, it was nighttime, so all I saw was like a city of lights, just so much lights. And she didn't tell me till we got there, and I could tell by then. And I'm like, where did you take me? So she took me in there because she says, you need boldness, son. And I had to get it. Okay. And so I was scared to death, but went in there with much prayer. And for the next 8 years, every Saturday, I would go and minister. Even when she wasn't there, I'd go in there and minister with whatever pastor went in there, and I would preach on the A yard, the B yard, and the C yard. There was 3 yards there. And one of the yards was for lifers. You know the term? We have some people in, not lifers in here. We have we have some law enforcement in here that know the term. But in the C yard was all the lifers. These are people that were never getting out. And I'd go in there and I'd do the AR. That's some of the new people got in there. They were just going to be now put in the other places. The B yard, there was some medical in there as well. And then the C yard was the hardcore. And I was always nervous going in there. And I think some of the inmates we called them brothers. You don't want to call it inmates. But some of the brothers saw that. And when I would come alone, they would actually walk beside me so that I had protection. And I would walk, my little self, into the thing. And you have to walk through the yard. They're playing handball and doing all this, just like the movies, in that big block. And then they would unlock the chapel, and then we'd go in there, and they'd all usher in, and there'd be like 80 of them packed in there. And sometimes the guards and chaplain would leave me there by myself. Okay. So if you're watching this, I'm putting in a complaint. No, and state of California. No, I'm joking. No. They would leave me in there, you know, and thank God, God was with me. And so I'd be behind the piano and I'd play and do our thing. And that nervousness began to go away because the men saw my faithfulness. Every week this young kid would come in and every week he would talk to us or lead us in worship. And some of these men all of them were hard criminals, but in the CR they were in love for life. They had nothing to look forward to. Package A, B, C, D, G, all those. What did they all have in common? Some of them had a lot of little pictures and all that. You can give to Lot. But all of them had one thing in common. That's me again. That's my senior picture. Okay. Actually, let's take you on a journey. Go to that first picture. We have the eighth grade. A big change happened, right? So don't worry, kids. You'll change too. Okay. Eighth grade. I think I was 90 pounds. Ninth grade. There's the 90 pounds. I gained my weight then, right? Ninth grade, 10th grade. I wasn't too happy at all. And I'm looking at the camera and like, get this over with. Okay. 11th grade. There I am. A change has happened. And then my final, my senior year. Going there. Okay. All of them, even the package that only had one picture in it, had what? The big picture. And it wasn't until going into the prisons and seeing men with their arms raised, tears on their cheek, some of them were permanent, but <I'm> just, but too soon? No, I don't. No. Many of them weren't, you know, they were pouring down. But I'm joking. But actually, I'm not. But yeah, they had tears running down their cheek as well. Arms raised, joy in their heart. We sing about joy. I didn't know how, because I had my whole life ahead of me. I haven't really made a bad decision. Kids, you're right now 16, 15 years old, 17. You really haven't made that bad of a decision that's life-altering, right? So I still had package A available to me. That's the big picture, right? But I also had enough for my family. I had enough to give to friends. I have enough, so much blessing, it's pouring out that I can just give some even to people that I don't even know. But as I make mistakes and consequences happen and things happen in my life, we move down from A, B, C, D, till sometimes we are in that position in prison where we only have the big picture and that's our salvation. But that was enough for these men. Because how many know God's in prison too? He can reach people. He can reach the unreachable. And sometimes it takes that moment. It takes that place. Andre Crouch wrote some of his best material from prison. Paul wrote a lot of this from prison. God still moves in the prison. God can still touch anybody and give them, even if it's package G, just the big picture. And as a young kid, we're selfish kids, right? We're selfish. We think of only ourselves. And choices today we don't really think will affect tomorrow until you go into some place like that where there is no hope, there is no peace, there is nothing. And for some people, it's the worst place on earth. They're being abused every day, you know? And we may not have mercy, but God does, because he sent the big picture for them. And it got me, allowed me to see these men with nothing. Their family will never speak to them again. They probably will never hear the words, I love you, other than ones written in here. But they had joy. They had love. I could sense it. I could tell. They knew the Bible better than me. They had more time, of course, to read it. But they knew it. If you were wrong, they would say, hey, brother, can I? And they'd talk to you afterward and say, and they'd talk to you about that. They knew God's word. How in the world could they find joy in their situation? How could they realize the fullness of God or the fulfilling of their calling when they're in there? What do they have to look forward to? Heaven. And that was enough for them. And sometimes it's not enough for us. Sometimes as Christians, we have made mistakes. How many have made mistakes? If you're not raising your hand, you just made one. You lied. The altars will be open later. We've all made mistakes. Some, of course, have been big mistakes. It's cost us marriages. It's cost us jobs. It's cost us friendships. It's cost us a lot. Freedom. Some small mistakes. We still have package A or B or C still available. But some of us, you know, the best we'll get is maybe package D. Enough for us and enough for our family. But will you find joy in that? Should you? But so many times as Christians, many times we look at the people that have package A and when will I get that? That's why I like to talk to you kids and say, you guys are in control now. Don't make mistakes that are going to take away package A, that are going to take away package B. Do you remember Jacob and Esau? Did Esau give away package A? For what? Food. I know kids who give a lot of things for food. Right, Erkin? No. Yeah. He's like, what? No, I guarantee you, he has some sort of chips or something on his person. He does. He's always has food, and he's the smallest little guy ever. But we'll give up a lot for a little because we don't take tomorrow into account, do we? And young people were the worst at that. We think we have all of our life to live. I like to tell this story. I want you guys to imagine this is package A beautiful vase. Let's say it's worth $1 million. And there was a young boy, and he was playing in his house, and his mom, of course, had this valuable vase, and it was in the room that no one was allowed. I know my grandma had that room, right? They're all nodding. Yes, she had the room. We had the living room where people can go, and then the living room that was off limits. It was just for looks. You could only walk in. I wish one day, don't go in there. Well, this mother had that same room, and little Johnny was playing with his, I couldn't find a toy or a ball. I found an orange. So he's playing with his favorite orange. And imagine this as being our plan D or G, right? It's whatever we have right now. This is what God has for us. It's our inheritance. You see, when mom dies, dad dies and all, young Johnny, this would be all his. But he's playing with the thing that's most valuable to him right now. It has to roll, of course. Should have picked something square. Okay. I did play basketball. This is not a basketball, though. I know, exactly. It's really bad. I wasn't a baseball player. So this means everything, right? And have you ever had a kid that, I mean, you buy them a toy and that means everything. They take it. You can't share it with anyone. No, mine, mine. They want it, right? That means everything to them. Youth, you have disregarded this because this is a boyfriend or girlfriend. Parents are like, come on, preach. You went there. I did. You know? But this could be a job promotion, too. This could be someone else's wife. This can be a lot of different things that we have our focus on, right? We forget the value of this. And this is what Johnny was doing, playing with his toy. And sure enough, he dropped it, and it bounced off and landed in the vase. If it's so expensive, we call it vase. But it landed in the vase. Priceless. And he snuck in the room and said, I'm gonna go get my ball before mom finds out. He put his hand in there and grabbed it. And just like Johnny, grabbing plan B or plan D or plan G, not letting go of it, he couldn't get it out. But that meant everything to him. I want it now. And his mom came rushing in and hearing the ruckus and said, what are you doing? Do you know how expensive this is? He says, I don't care. I want my toy. Give it to me. I'll show you how you can get your toy. No, I want it now. I want it now. And he was getting ready to smash it so that he can get his ball out. When his mom said, trust me, just let it go. He let it go. Pull your hand out. He pulled his hand out. She took it and poured out what meant most to him out, and both were saved. But many times, we risk our inheritance. We risk package A, all for this. By just letting go, we can have both. And I want you guys to remember that. Youth, remember that. Every time you see a jar, package A, you know. But that's our life. It's not to sit there and compare ourselves to others, because a lot of times we do that. We compare ourselves to others. Did you know David could have compared himself to others? What was David known for? Worship, right? He was a worshiper. That's what he did out in the fields. That's what he did, right? He worshiped God with everything he had. What do you do in a temple? Worship. What was the one thing he wasn't allowed to build? A temple. That was his plan A. I think he was created for that because of mistakes he made, because he looked at the orange, right? His son had to build the temple. He had to live a plan B. But I don't think David sat there going, well, then I'm not going to live for God if I can't have everything. There are consequences, and sometimes you really inspect your life and say, I need to be realistic in this. God, I've made mistakes, and his love and his grace and his mercy forgives you. Yes, the big picture's there. You'll have the big picture. You'll go to heaven. But sometimes we spend the rest of our lives scratching, clawing for package A when it's out of our grasp, right? It wasn't there for David anymore. Samson, did he have a package A at one time? He saw a lot of oranges, right? Any orange, he went after. But it took the final act of his life, right? He pushed the pillar down, it brought everything down. I want you really to look in your own life and say, hey, am I sitting there scratching and crying and going after something that's not really attainable? Am I jealous of others? Am I not moving in ministry because God didn't give me? Or are you going to be like those inmates that if it's only the big picture, I will bless you, Lord? Because sometimes you go through tests, purification, because God wants to purify you. And pure gold is melted down, melted down, melted down, melted down, right? And re-poured. And God wants to do that in our life, to melt down and get those impurities out so that what is poured is pure. And sometimes we give up in the test. We give up in the fire. We're never poured out. So as the choir comes back up, we're going to sing a song called Your Love. And I really want you to understand this. The words say, your love is extravagant. Lord, your friendship is intimate. Now I find I'm moving to the rhythm of your grace. It's your fragrance that's intoxicating, and it comes in our secret place. Now I'm spread wide in the arms of Christ. And there is where I find a love that covers my sin. There is no greater love that I've ever known that you consider me a friend. Because it's your love. I want it to capture my heart again. Can you stand? As you sing this song, think of the one who saved you. Think of the one who's given you endless mercy, who calls you a friend, knowing everything you've done, who loves you more than anything, even though he knows the most about you. Yeah. expressing your love.
Your love is extravagant. Your friendship.
One more time, spread wide.
Spread wide in the arms of Christ. It's a love that covers sin. No greater love have I ever known. But you consider me a friend. Capture my heart again.
Capture
my heart again.
We'll sing it again.
Capture my heart again.
Capture
my heart again.
To our heart, God. Amen. Amen. His love is awesome. It amazes me. Amen. About his love. Oh, there were walls between.
Your love is greater. Your love is stronger. Your love awakens.
One more time.
Your love is greater. Your love is stronger. Your love awakens me. Your love is greater. Your love is stronger.
Your love awakens.
Your love awakens me.
Count on one thing, the same God who never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now, it's in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. Come on, sing.
Yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley.
Your answer to be. Satan will come, he will try to trip you up. People will come, they'll try to trip you up, but I want your answer to be yes. And this last song, I want you to give it your all, because this song says, hold to God's unchanging hand. This world changes, your life changes, things happen, but don't give up the hand of God. He'll keep you, he'll protect you. You can't trust yourself, you gotta trust God. Amen. So I want this song to be with you all week. Hold to God's unchanging hand. Amen.
Hold on,
to his way,
hold on,
hold on,
hold on,
you better. where you almost wanted to give up. Satan almost, he convinced you, right? But we're here because we hung on, amen? Yeah.